Hi, I'm Ramya.
I'm Manasa.
This is Soumya.
I'm Pavan Guna.
We are here to present our topic, solar cells. I know all of us know it's a fact that all life depends on and comes from the sun. So it's almost 1.4 kilowatts per square meter of energy coming from the sun, which is available on the land. Why not use it in a useful way when we are getting such everlasting power? Here comes the need to implement a solar cell. It's an electrical device which converts energy from sunlight into electrical energy by photovoltaic effect. In other words, it's a structure. You can imagine that as a device which converts the photons into electronic movement and converts into electrical current. A number of individual cells, when assembled, are connected together, forms a solar panel. Here's the solar cell, or the solar panel, which has a positive and negative ends, and it is connected to a lamp, and you can see the flow of electrons. The basic operation behind this is when the photon hits the solar cells, it triggers the electron movements, and this converts into electrical energy or electricity. Here shows the positive and negative ends of the solar panel. This helps in capturing the electrons in the form of electric current. The solar cells are made of monocrystalline silicon wafer, which has positive and negative ends. Few solar cells are made of silicon material, which is doped with boron and phosphorus for conducting electricity. We have three generations of development under solar cells. The first generation consists of large area and high quality single junction devices. This has a low production cost. The second generations have been developed to address energy requirements and the production cost of the solar cells. And the third generation to enhance the poor electrical performance. And this is basically aimed to reduce the production cost.
The figure shows the life cycle of solar panel. It starts with collecting and refining the raw material. Then we manufacture and assemble the material as required. Then we use it, and after the life of the solar cell, we again recycle them. Here is the structure of the solar cell, and it has six different parts. The first one is the encapsulation part, the second one is the contact grid, the third one is the anti-reflective coating, the fourth one is the N-type silicon, fifth one is the P-type silicon, and the last one is the back contact. So the encapsulation part, it's made from sources like glass and plastic, and it acts like a cap for the entire solar cell. The contact grid, it's made with metal, and it collects the electrons. The anti-reflective coating is made with a suitable refractive index and thickness. So this layer helps the light to point into the solar cell. The N-type silicon, this is made by doping the silicon with compounds that will have some valence electrons. And this may be either phosphorus or arsenic. As the process, this process requires four electrons, and the fifth electron will be used for conduction. The P-type silicon, it is made by doping the silicon with compounds that contain one less valence electrons. And here a hole is created. The last one is the back contact. This is made from the metal, and this covers the entire back surface of the solar cell. And this also acts like a conductor.
And I'm going to explain about the working process of the solar cell. The photon is responsible for the photoelectric effect. And when we know the photoelectric effect is when the photon that changes to the electron, then there leaves an energy. Thus, it's known as photoelectric effect. the p-n junction, how the p-n junction is formed. There are two types of junction, the p-junction and the n-junction. The p-junction is the majority is the holes, and the n-junction, the majority is the electrons. And here's the interesting part. At the darkened solar eclipse, at the p-n junction, the depletion layer is formed. This depletion, when the p and the both the p and the n junction is combined, then the electrons leaves the holes and goes to the n junction. Here you can see that the n junction and p junction. Here there is a deflection zone. That is deflection zone doesn't allow the holes and the electrons to go over side. It just defend from that. And here is the quotation for the current. P is equal to VI, where V is the voltage and I is the current, and P is the product source. Here it shows the n-type and p-type. There the n-type is known for the negative channel, and p-type is known for the positive channel. When these two are connected, then it a bulb glows. We get the current and the bulb glows. And the applications over this solar cell. The solar cell are applied for the powering space, vehicles, and they are reliable and economically, and they are good to use, and that's it. They are high efficiency, and the energy is used immediately and can be stored in the backwards. Thank you.
I'm here to discuss something about some advantages and disadvantages of the solar cell, as every technology has its own pros and cons. The solar power is actually a far-reaching. Although solar power is relatively a new energy source, it may easily become the most important energy source of the future. This is because of some advantages over here. First thing is, the solar cells require little maintenance because there are no moving parts that must actually be maintained. And the solar cells last for a lifetime. And the solar power is actually a renewable resource. This means that we are not in a danger of depleting its reserves. And the main important, the primary advantage of solar power is it's non-polluting. Unlike oil and solar power usage does not emit any greenhouse gases, nor does not acquisition or harm the ecosystems of the through spilling. So this is one of the primary advantage of the solar power. And of course, the energy and the heat from the sun is free. So once the solar panels are set up, there are no electrical expenses. And the equipments also have the long life. And it also have some good feasible cell efficiency. And the solar power is incredibly versatile. A variety of inventions, like we have many applications of solar power. So may be powered by it, including cars, solar water heaters, and fountains, and buildings, and satellites. Along with the advantages of the solar power, it's worth remarking upon the disadvantages of it. So these includes the main disadvantages: sunlight may not be available all the time. So the readily available resource in some areas of the world is not available. This is the main disadvantage, and the cost of the solar cell is quite high. That depends upon how many watts you use. Like for our home or house purposes, we need 2 kilowatts of solar panels, where each watt costs for $12. So that comes up to $12,000 for a solar panel to install in a house. So we can conclude by saying that the solar energy will become the most important and cost efficient energy in the future. And though the solar cells are expensive and its installation costs a lot, but in the long run, it can run up to 25 to 30 years minimum, and it's proven to be the economically advantageous. Thank you. Questions?
Any questions? Solar at night. Okay. Give them a hand, please.